to the Crazy Town Podcast. I'm Jonas.
And I'm TNT Dot. I'm about to explode one. Let's crack it to another one.
TNT, we got a very interesting story today.
All right.
A controversial story.
Uh-oh, are we talking about some dark topics, Joni?
I would say it's a pretty dark topic.
Oh, okay. All
right. So what I want to do is, before we get any farther into the episode, I want to give a trigger warning. We are talking about assisted death by self.
That assisted by self.
I mean, I didn't want to say the word. It can be triggering just saying it.
He wants to unalive is what they say in the TikTok realm.
No, is that what it is? So, yes. So anyways, in Switzerland, assisted suicide is legal.
Okay. Assisted unaliving.
You know, so, you know, I think that's where Kevorian was back in the day. Dr. Kevorian, he would do, like, the assisted stuff.
Yeah.
Got in trouble. A company, I don't know if the company's name is Sarco, but they have what is called an assisted unalive pod. Look.
Let's take a look at
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah. We have. If you're watching the Ytube video,
explain what
we
this
can
pod
show
is,
it. It looks kind of like a space capsule. It looks, I don't know. There's, like, a window on the front. Oddly enough. Then it has like a door that opens up kind of like a Lamborghini and then closes.
So it does have, it has suicide doors.
Oh my God. It's not funny, but like it.
Oh my God.
I just realized those are called suicide doors,
it
aren't
does
they?
Have suicide.
So.
They did that shit on purpose.
I mean,
I'm convinced that
probably.
They did that on purpose.
But essentially, oddly enough, that thing is 3D printed.
Really?
Yeah. And basically what happens is you crawl inside and you close the door and there's a window on the top so you can see out. And then inside there's a button and when you press it, it releases nitrogen gas and you basically pass out in a few seconds and then you just die from oxygen deprivation while you sleep. So it's peaceful. It's like you pass out, you just get deprived of oxygen and you die. So the first lady who ever used this pod... They are portable, so that says it's portable there. What they do is they, like, this lady had a debilitating disease. She was like 60-something years old, very bad health.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They took it out into the woods because she wanted to die in the forest.
Yeah, I think that was the picture.
Yeah, and that was the picture. So they took it out there. They closed the door. She's able to, like, go out into nature, look out into the forest, and then she hits the button. And then the gas comes and she passes away on her own terms.
Wow.
They then arrested the folks that brought the pod. Because obviously they, you know, they're saying, like, if you see someone trying to kill themselves and you don't assist, like Phil Collins' Air of the Night kind of thing. Like, are you culpable because they're dying? Are you not helping them or whether they want to die or not? I'm sure they'll probably end up getting off because it's like, it's kind of like, it's legal there. In a way or something, but
yeah, I wonder what they would even arrest them for.
Assisting a suicide.
Yeah, I think the problem comes in is like the assisting thing, because it's hard to tell if the person was willing and compliant in this thing. Like, you could easily just like commit a crime, and then people have to be like, was this a crime, or did this person actually just was depressed in their life?
Yeah. Well, here's the other piece that I get. If someone wants to end their own life and they're all alone, they do it by themselves. They have to figure it out. They got to plan it. You know, from knowing, I know a few therapists. You know, they say a lot of people think about and talk about suicide, and you don't have to really start worrying about the person unless they're actively planning it. Because the planning part is the part that most people can't get over. People hate their life. People want to die, quote unquote. But to actually plan the way you're going to do it is the hard part. Like, that's when the realization of it all hits. And, like, that's – so you're taking the steps. This takes that out of their hands.
Wow.
So it's like, if you want to die and all you have to do is lay in a thing and hit a button, it's almost like an impulse. Like,
yeah, yeah.
But if you have to go get the pod yourself, take the pod out there yourself, lay in it yourself, do the thing or whatever you plan on doing.
I feel like you can still open. It's not like the pod locks.
No, they're free to do whatever they want, but all they have to do is hit a button and that's it. You know, so it's like it makes the process
too easy.
Too easy, I think.
You have to 3D print this thing. You have to buy it. You have to go to the Amazon cart and press.
I mean, I don't know, man. It's a very touchy subject. Obviously, for many reasons, people have lost a lot of people they care about from this. But it's like, I don't know, man. Part of me believes that if like you're so unhappy or you're so ill or you're so whatever, I mean, do you get the choice to stop living? Like, yeah, it makes your family upset and all of that, but like,
you get the choice. It's not that hard to off yourself.
I mean,
it's not, man. I feel like if you really want it done, it's not that hard to do. So I feel like regardless of what the law may say, you definitely have the choice.
Yeah. You know, what's very interesting about it is like, I feel like if it was legal everywhere and like, but you had to go through like a process, it would probably prevent a lot of people from doing it, because I think a lot of people do it when, you know, they're at their worst, they can't reach out to anyone. But if they're like, oh, I'm going to do this, let me like plan it out, I'll give everyone preparation that I'm no longer going to be around, you might find the love that you're looking for, or find the thing that you're like, nobody cares. And like, people are like trying to talk you out of it, like whatever. I don't know, man. It's weird, dude.
I will say is that currently we in this country, we do have a 988 suicide hotline number.
Yeah, but that's awesome now that they made it so simple. It used to be whatever Logic put out that one. I was like, yeah, it was just a bunch of random numbers before.
Yeah, I don't remember it at all. Not a Logic listener, sorry. But as far as like what you're talking about, that's like building an infrastructure of like therapists and doctors who are going to be able to like see all of these people just to make it legal. I mean, is it more jobs? I guess, but in those like those very hyper focused fields, I don't see it. I don't see America being able to comp for that. And you know,
no,
I don't. I get it.
And no one wants to promote that.
Exactly. So you just, when you don't want something done, you make it illegal.
Yeah. I mean,
yeah. Oh, not only are you going to fail at killing yourself, but now you have to go to prison. See, that's how you deter people from doing it.
Oh yeah, that's wild, because
it is wild
because it's technically illegal. So it's like,
if
you fail, you get in trouble
or fined or something. Oh great. But I think if the cops catch you trying to do it, then they might like give you help. And I think that's what a lot of people are seeking when you see them doing the very public displays of it.
Oh yeah, man.
Because like I say, it's not difficult to do. It's just that a lot of people don't really want to go. And I don't blame them. I don't see why anybody would want to die. It doesn't, I don't, man. Life is too good, man. There's plenty of time in a day to do whatever you want, man.
Yeah. I mean, I think a lot of times the people want the pain they're feeling to stop.
Yeah.
And they don't know any other way to get rid of it, where there's plenty of ways to like try to cope or work through your problems or whatever.
Big facts.
I feel very different about like depression suicide and like I'm already dying from a disease, I just want to make it end faster.
Yeah, and that is who it should be used for, is like those people who are in that painful state of their final days on this planet, man. And it would be beneficial for them to pass faster. And if they are like, yes, just let me go.
Right.
Or like if I'm put into a debilitative state because of a horrific accident, and it's like I'm never going to have the life I once had, and I have to watch my family come and like, you know what? I think you should have a choice in that. You know?
Right. Well, it's all about quality of life, right? Like, so if like you're like, I'm dying, there's zero chance I'm going to live, but I'm just going to be laying in a hospital bed in pain for the next 6 months to a year as my body breaks down, do I want to end it?
Yeah. I mean, but like I said, man, there's choices.
There is, man. I don't know, man. Choices. It's a very, I think people do a lot of like not paying it. Like, I don't want to say not paying attention, but like, it's like one of those things, like, if you think, it's like when you start thinking about it, and if you're like, hey, would this be a viable thing for society? Like, it gets very weird very fast.
Yeah.
Like, people know it's out there. People know people that have done it. People know, you know, like, I don't know how many people have been affected by it. A lot, because there's a lot of people that, I mean, essentially overdoses are almost like suicide in a way. Because, like, you know what I mean? Like, you're jacking yourself up with that much drugs, you know there's a chance that you're going to not live.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So, I don't know, man. It's just wild. So anyways, you know, a little serious one for today, but That's all the time we have for today's episode. Go to thecrazynow.com and subscribe for Jonas.
TNT.
Oh, yeah.